Hello and welcome to this short lesson. This is an introduction to our next lesson cycle, which will be how to write chemical reactions. Before writing chemical reactions, you must learn how to identify each and every chemical compound in inorganic chemistry. There are four major groups in chemistry: acids, hydroxides, oxides, and salts. All acids always start with the H plus ion in their formulas. For example, HCl, H2S, H2SO4, and so on. Next are hydroxides. All hydroxides end with OH minus ion. For example, NaOH, CaOH times 2, and AlOH times 3. Let's talk about oxides. Now, oxides can be divided into two major groups: basic oxides and acidic oxides. Now, we can identify oxides very easily because they are always composed of only two elements, of which one is oxygen. Now, basic oxides are also called metal oxides because they have metal in their composition. Few formulas for basic oxides: Na2O, CaO, and Ni2O3. As you can see, all basic oxides are only made from two elements. One is metal and the other is oxygen. For acidic oxides, we have non-metal and oxygen in their composition. For example, CO2, SO2, and P2O5. Now, which elements are metals and which are non-metals? I have a periodic table here, and in the third A group, under boron, you should see a black line that goes throughout A groups in the periodic table and looks like a staircase. On the left side of that line resides all metals, and on the right side, you have all non-metals. Lastly, there are salts. The easiest way to discern which compound is salt and which is not is to ask yourself a question: is this compound an acid, a hydroxide, or an oxide? If the answer is no, then we are dealing with a salt. For example, KCl. It's not an acid because it doesn't start with H, and not a hydroxide because it doesn't have OH. Can't be oxide either because it doesn't have oxygen. So all that's left is salt. Next is Na2SO4. Once again, it can't be acid. No H at the start. And no OH at the end means it's not a hydroxide. It has oxygen, but oxides have only two elements. And there we have three: sodium, sulfur, and oxygen. So once again, we are left with salt. Here I have five compounds, and let's assign each compound to its class. Cl2O7 has only two elements. One is oxygen, so it's oxide. Now, Cl is a non-metal. If we look at a periodic table, we'll see chlorine on the right side of the line. So Cl2O7 is an acidic oxide. NiOH times 2 has an OH group, so it's hydroxide. In H3PO4, we see H at the beginning, so it's definitely an acid. FeBr is a salt because there is no H plus or OH minus ions present. Also, this compound is made from two elements, but there is no oxygen present, so it can't be oxide either. The last one is MgO. It's made from two elements and has an oxygen atom, so it's oxide. Because Mg is a metal, we have a basic oxide. Thank you for watching this lesson, and please subscribe to this channel for more chemistry content. And like always, I leave a few exercises with answers that you can try on your own. And see you in the next lesson.